you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Most holy and righteous God, you have called us to give our lives to you, to repent, and to ensure that our souls are prepared, even as we look forward to your second coming in glory. May we recognize the need to practice loving our neighbors. May we see the need, O God, to be mindful that as we love one another, we are really showing our commitment, our desire to enter the kingdom of God. And so bless us now in this act of worship. And we pray through the power of your name, that we give up our souls, our lives to you before it is too late. And this we ask in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The hymn for the procession. These are the days of Elijah.
Of love. In their old age,
God gave to Zechariah and Elizabeth a son called John. John spoke to the people bravely in the desert, denied his own comforts, and prepared to die for what he believed. John taught that we should share what we have with others and treat each other kindly and show God's love. He did this because he cared for people and wanted them to repent and find God's forgiveness.
Make all things new. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people from one another, and separate the sheep from the goats. Our hope is also to live with confidence in newness and fulfillment of life. And his teaching, said, I give you a new commandment. In his teaching, Jesus said, I give you a new commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. So you are to love one another. St. John 13. He demonstrated this love through forgiveness and then doing his life for humanity. Greater love has no man than this, that a man laid down for his life for his friends. Jesus taught that if there is love among us, then all we will know we are his disciples. We light the candle of love to remind us that love is the fulfillment of the law and truth. Christ, we experience the love of God, which has been set upright in our hearts by the Holy Spirit is given to us.
holy and mighty, holy and immortal one, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one, have mercy upon us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one, have mercy upon us.
Chapter 5, reading verses 1 to 9. Take off your garment of your sorrow and affliction, O Jerusalem, and put on forever the beauty of the glory from God. Put on the robe of the righteousness that comes from God. Put on your head the diadem of the glory of the everlasting, for God will show your splendor everywhere on the heaven. For God will give you evermore the name, righteous, peace, godly, glory. Arise, O Jerusalem, stand upon the height. Look toward the east and see your children gathered from west and east at the word of the Holy One, rejoicing that God has remembered them. For they went out from you on foot, led away by their enemies. But God will bring them back to you, carried in glory, as on a royal throne. For God has ordered that every high mountain and the everlasting hills be made low, and the valleys filled up to make level ground, so that Israel may walk safely in the glory of God. The woods and every fragrant tree, fragrant tree, have shaded Israel at God's command. For God will lead Israel with joy in the light of his glory, and the mercy and righteousness that comes from him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us stand as we sing the Benedictus.
Mm-hmm.
reading from the Word of God, written in Philippians chapter 1, verses 3 to 11. I thank my God every time I remember you, constantly praying with joy in every one of my prayers for all of you, because of your sharing in the gospel from the first day until now. I am confident of this, that the one who began a good work among you will bring it to completion by the day of Jesus Christ. It is right for me to think this way about all of you, because you hold me in your heart, for all of you share in God's grace with me, both in my imprisonment and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel of God. For God is my witness, how I long for all of you with the compassion of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may overflow more and more with knowledge and full insight to help you to determine what is best, so that in the day of Christ you may be pure and blameless, having produced the harvest of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ for the glory and praise of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The hymn for the bride, number 42.
Thank you.
in the 15th year of the reign of Emperor Tiberius, when Pontius Pilate was governor of Judea, and Herod was ruler of Galilee, and his brother Philip, ruler of the region of Iturea, and Trachonitis, and Lysanias, ruler of Abilene, during the high priests of Annas and Caiaphas, the word of God came to John, son of Zechariah, in the wilderness. He went into all the region around the Jordan, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins, as it is written in the book of the words of the prophet Isaiah, "The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. Every valley shall be filled, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough ways made smooth, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God." The Gospel of Christ. To repent and give their lives to God. Additionally, in quoting from the prophet Isaiah, John in Luke 3 verse 4 identified himself as this voice, the voice of one crying out in the wilderness to warn the people, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. This call to prepare the way of the Lord speaks of the need to carefully reflect on our lives and see what is it that we need to change in order to make our souls right with God. The chorus, creating me a clean heart and renew a right spirit in me, speaks exactly of this. As if we are to make this part in spot straight in our lives, if it is that we are to keep focus on Jesus, we must constantly ask God to cleanse and transform us from within. As John continued the analogy of Isaiah the prophet, he further stated in verses 5 to 6, everybody shall be filled, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall become straight. The rough places shall become leveled ways, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. So notice here, my friends, that in straightening God's path in our lives, we will be able to realize the salvation of God. This, however, will require that the metaphoric valleys and mountains in our lives, called sin, should be filled up or leveled so that the resulting outcome is a plain or flat piece of land, which symbolizes the ultimate commitment to walk the straight and narrow way. So for all those crooked ways in our lives, my brothers and sisters, we need to straighten them before it is too late. This call to repentance, to ask God to forgive us of all our sins and renew us from within, must be one born out of a commitment to doing God's will, even as we seek to serve God for the rest of our lives. One can therefore see that as we seek God's repentance, that this is definitely in keeping with the work that we need to put in to save our souls, especially as we await the Messiah's second coming in glory. Chief among our responsibilities is the need to love one another as God has loved us. So having lit the candle of love today, we are being reminded that if we are to enter the kingdom of God, we must refrain or desist from causing harm to one another. If this is what we have been doing, God is not pleased, my friends. And we certainly have not been making the Lord's path straight in our lives. If we really love God, tell me, my friends, how can we conceive the idea of wanting to take a weapon to harm someone? And how can we find it in our hearts to speak evil of others? If this is what we have been doing, we must seek God's repentance and turn from our evil ways. This state of mind cannot enable us to prepare our hearts to meet our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, at his coming. And we who are the baptized, having been made a new creation in God through the waters of baptism, are called to live up to the standard of straightening those crooked ways and leading by example. If we are to be a part of God's kingdom, love for God and love for others must be our focus as we strive to be compassionate, kind-hearted, and supportive towards one another. The Most Reverend Michael Corrie, the current presiding bishop and primate of the Episcopal Church of America, writing his spoke the power of love. And I quote, when love is the way, there's plenty good room. Plenty good room for all of God's children. Because when love is the way, we treat each other well, like we are actually a family. When love is the way, we know that God is the source of us all. And we are brothers and sisters, children of God. Now, brothers and sisters, that's a new heaven, a new world, a new human family. This is where we need to be, my friends. This is where we need to be in our relationships with each other. And so wherever there are animosities, quarrels, and division, let us seek to reconcile with our family members and friends, thus making the Lord's path straight in our lives. So even as we prepare our homes and look forward to celebrating the festivities surrounding Christ's birth, the fun, the merrymaking, the eating and the drinking, let us also be mindful of the need to ensure that our souls are in a state of readiness to meet our Lord when he returns to judge the world. In the words of Philippians 1 verse 10, we need to allow our love to overflow with knowledge, so that in the day of Christ we may be pure and blameless. It is the love of God that transforms our hearts. And this is what will enable us to see our weaknesses, recognize our wrongs, and repent of our sinful ways. My brothers and sisters in Christ, we need to allow God's love to infiltrate our hearts and lives, as this is how we will be able to make his path straight. Let us therefore ensure that we prepare our lives today, repent of all our sins, as tomorrow may be too late. Amen. Page 104, let us stand as we affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen or unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became a man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
prayer of intercession. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, we give you thanks for all who have told us of your love and your presence among us. We give thanks for John the Baptist, preparing the way for our Savior. We give thanks for the apostles and evangelists. Mighty God, guide and empower all preachers of the word and ministers of the sacraments. We pray especially for our leaders, for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Howard, the Diocesan Bishop and Archbishop of the West Indies, Leon, Suffragan Bishop, Ronaldo and Orlando, and for all others who hold office in your church. Bless all who proclaim your love and glory through the arts, music, broadcasting, and publishing, all who prepare hearts and minds for your coming. Blessed Lord, hear us.
And set our people free.
We pray for those who are called to lead and manage this country, Jamaica land we love. Patrick, the Governor General, Andrew, the Prime Minister, Mark, Leader of the Opposition, and all members of Parliament, the Senate, councillors, and group leaders. Lord of freedom and grace, we pray for all who are held prisoner by tyranny and oppression, all whose eyes are blind to your glory and deaf to your word. Remember all who do not know or love you, all whose lives are darkened by fear. Blessed Lord, hear us.
And set our people free.
We give thanks to all who taught us the faith and led us to you. For all who have given us a glimpse of your glory. We pray for teachers and Sunday school teachers, for families, friends, and all who are dear to us. Remember any who have special difficulties or troubles at this time. Blessed Lord, hear us. Lord of love, we pray for all who are consumed with hatred, all who do not know how to accept or receive forgiveness, all who are not at peace with themselves or the world. Remember all who are anxious and fearful at this time. We pray for all who are weakened by illness or incapacity. We pray for sick and shut-ins, especially Reverend Asselinda and those of this cure and of this church. We also remember all persons who are suffering from COVID-19. Remember this time the frontline duty workers. We pray that you would touch and heal them. Blessed Lord, hear us.
And set our people free.
Lord of glory, you destroy the darkness of the shadow of death and open the kingdom of heaven to your loved ones. We pray for the departed, that in your love they may rejoice in peace. Blessed Lord, hear us.
And set our people free.
During this moment of silence, let us pray for needs and those of others. Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Page 123, the Act of Penitence. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and God will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Using Form B on page 124, let us therefore confess our sins. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not loved ourselves as we ought. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon, deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. If you are offering your gift at the altar, and there remember that your brother or sister has something against you, peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace be with you. Peace. Peace. The hymn for the offertory. 347.
Mm-hmm.
26, Form B for the presentation of the offerings. Father, we offer you these gifts which you have given us, this bread, this wine, this money. We thankfully offer ourselves, our lives and our work, to become through your Holy Spirit. As you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death, and to make us heirs in him of eternal life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith.
Thank you.
His glorious resurrection and ascension, his continual intercession for us in heaven, and looking for his coming again in glory, we offer in thanksgiving this holy and life-giving sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering, and grant that we will eat and drink these holy gifts, may be filled with your Holy Spirit, and become one body in Christ, and serve in unity, constancy, and peace. May he make us a perpetual offering to you, and enable us in communion with Blessed Mary, Blessed Mark, and the whole company of heaven to share in the inheritance of your saints. With him and in him and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise.
Oh,
to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one.
Thank you.
The Lord bless you. The Lord make his face shine.
Thank you.
47, the first post communion prayer. Jesus Christ, Son of God, make yourself known to us. Jesus Christ, Son of God, make yourself known through us. Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, speak through us to others. Almighty Father, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. May he who share his body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We upon whom your Spirit shines give light to the world. Help us to continue in faithful witness to your word, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Bow your heads for God's blessing. Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you, and scatter the darkness from before your path. And the blessing of God Almighty the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, and remain with you always. Amen. Let me extend a special welcome to us who are gathered here today. A special welcome to those who have joined us online. And even as we seek to have our Advent study after service, I want to wish you all a blessed rest of the week. Remember, my friends, please practice the protocols, especially with this new variant that is out. Wear your masks, sanitize frequently, practice social distance. And again, I continue to remind us, for those of us who are not yet vaccinated, please go out and do so. May God bless you all. Recessional hymn. 523. 523.
Thank you.
to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.